Suppose we can travel to Japan. Not that anyone can do so in this current COVID situations. It would be good to learn some simple Japanese, so that we can immerse better in the local culture. And rather than a full-fledged language app, we can have something light, like a Telegram bot. The bots can translate English words to Japanese and provide the Japanese pronunciation recording. For example, let's key in good afternoon.
こんにちは.
You can also speak into the mic and the bot will check your pronunciations. Simple but useful. But in the short demo video for the past 20 seconds, you have actually seen not one, not two, but three AI applications. Speech-to-text, text-to-speech, and speech translation. Building the model for any one of these three applications is challenging enough on its own, but you can actually build the bot pretty easily yourself. That is all thanks to Google Cloud APIs. And in this article, we have laid out the steps that you can follow to set up the bot you have just seen, without spending a single cent. The article link has been placed in the description box, so go ahead and try it. In the article, we have also shown how to deploy the bots in the cloud so that you can talk to it anytime, anywhere. The code base is pretty simple, just a config.py file for configurations, an app.py file for the main script, a Google API.py file to place the functions for using the Google Cloud APIs, and lastly, the requirements.txt to list the packages used. After inputting your configurations, just run the app.py file and your bot is ready to talk. In the next few videos, we will also talk about each of the AI applications to gain better insights as well as to take a look at some of the potential open source models that we can use as replacement for the Google Cloud APIs. Have fun playing with your bot, and if you face any issues, please feel free to sound out in the comments too. See you next time.
またね。